Hi everybody, today we are going to discuss the various kinds of gloss finishes that are available in the market. I wanted to make a separate video of it so that an individual customer can understand the various gloss finishes that are going into the market. There are ones in laminate, in paints, in acrylic, and it gets very difficult to identify what is a better gloss or a superior gloss as compared to an inferior one. So we'll be going into those details today, so as you can yourself identify what is a better gloss, what is a better finish. So the various aspects that one needs to identify in gloss finishes can basically be chopped down into the reflection. How well are you able to see your own reflection or the reflection of, say, a tube light or a bulb into that finish? That would actually dictate what is the reflection quality of that finish. Then we have the brightness. How brightly is it able to reflect the light? Is it too bright? Is it dull? Thirdly, there is the quality of waves. It is also called the orange peel effect, in which on a larger surface, how is the reflection bending over a larger surface when you move or during movement? Are there too many of the bending of that reflection that is happening? How often is it happening? So generally, good finishes, they don't have that many bends and that many waves. And then we have the indents. On a larger surface or even on a small surface, are there some areas where the reflection is not that good, or the light is a little dull? Are there some spots? These are generally the quality issues that come up. And the last one is basically the scratch resistance. Generally, after looking at all these gloss effects, how scratch resistant is it? Sometimes the gloss would be really nice, the brightness would be very well, but it would be very highly perceptible to, it can be very easily damaged. So one needs to look into that as well. Major points that we'll be going. Now we will explain these different finish aspects on various gloss finish samples that we have, so that you yourself can identify which one has a better reflection, which one has indents, which one basically has more brightness, and so on and so forth. So the first finish we're going to start off is with the gloss laminate. So these are laminates which are set to be of a gloss finish. As you can see, you are barely able to make out the shape of the light. The gloss is, the brightness is not that much also. Fortunately, these laminates are generally very high in scratch resistance. You won't find a lot of scratches. Once you move it a bit, you won't see a lot of waves, but you might find some indents, which basically means that there are some small deformities, probably due to plywood. The next finish that we have is what we call the Glossmeister, or an acrylic UV finish. People call it gloss UV also sometimes. So this is actually a better sample of a UV that we are using. In it, you can see that the reflection is much better as compared to that of a gloss laminate. This is a little less scratch resistant as compared to the gloss laminate, but it's still very durable, very nice. A little bit of waves. It doesn't have a lot of indents though. The reflection is quite nice, but still the light and the source of light is a little blurry, as well as the reflection of the light is not too bright. It's not too reflective. Next finish that we have is that of an acrylic. So this is a, as you can see, the reflection of the light is very clear. It's almost mirror-like. You can see that the brightness is also somewhat better, if not at par. It's pretty better as compared to the UV option. So it's a little more brighter. You can see the waves also in it, though generally they are lesser as compared to that of a UV gloss. on a bigger surface there might be some waves, less indents. The brightness in it is not too high. Generally, this is a very suitable board for kitchens, for wardrobes. Even the UV board is very nice. As you go to the acrylic one though, the scratch resistance is a little more less as compared to that of, say, a laminate. Moving on to our other finish, which is the lacquer and the paint. Now, as you can see, the reflection is not as good as that of acrylic finish. The reflection is a little blurry. There are a little bit of waves. The waves are not that much. And as you can see, if you see the reflection of the light in it, the reflection of the light is very bright as compared to acrylic and the other options. This is actually why most of the paints are considered to be more brighter and they bring out a little more light in the room. The last finish is actually what we call a lacquer glass. So this is a glass with backside painted. As you can see, the reflection is perfect. Generally, the reflection of the light is a bit too high in this. These are not very durable, a little susceptible to scratches also, so not very scratch resistant. The good thing is the reflection is perfect. They reflect the light very perfectly. The look is very high end and very luxurious. It does not have any waves because it's glass, so it doesn't bend that much. And that's why it's a very good finish to have if you're looking into gloss aspects. Now, hopefully you guys know what are the various factors which you can use to rank all kinds of different gloss levels. And you can then now go into the market, judge for yourself which gloss aspects and which are the aspects which are better suited for your kitchen. Some people might want to go a bit more brighter way, a little more flashy. The lacquer paints are a great option for that. They are used in furniture, in wardrobes, very thoroughly because of this reason. A middle ground is an acrylic. That's also a very great finish. It has the perfect balance of being superior in reflection as well as in brightness. It's not too high. It's also decently scratch resistant, so the durability is also good. UV is also a very good option, though generally UV, there are a lot of options in the market. One needs to make sure that the waves are not too much. Sometimes some options in the market have too much waves or their reflection is not that well. So one needs to keep that in mind a bit more. Laminates are mostly ever durable. They are not a luxurious finish. The reflectiveness is not that high, but they are really very, really durable. They are very scratch resistant. And they still reflect. They still have the brightness reflection factor, which is decent enough, and it lifts up the kitchen in their own way. And lastly, we have the glass. It's a luxurious finish. It's a little tough to handle because it can break. But if you're able to manage it, it's one of the best finishes that one can have. Its reflection is perfect. The brightness is also very good, as well as it provides a very luxurious look to your kitchen. It also makes, because of its high reflection, it makes the kitchen looks more spacious. Also, you feel like you're having more space psychologically, which is a very good factor if you are having a small kitchen. If you like the information that we've said, like the video, share it with people that might be building their homes, that might require it, and do leave comments below. We'll try to respond to them with all the information that we have.